welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So the next thing that we looked at was a great mum introduces her kids to independence.
Yes.
And really we were talking about the fact that you can't mollycoddle your kids. You've got to basically at some point release them.
Yeah.
And can't wrap them up in cotton wool.
No, exactly. And that's, as mums, we're entrusted with caretaking.
Yeah.
I know you take ownership over your family, mums, but we're caretaking them. We are raising them for that time when they can flee the nest and they can become independent.
Right.
Men and women.
Yeah.
And that's our job to do.
Yeah.
And I think that's, for me, that is the most rewarding part.
Yeah.
It's actually when I see my daughter making good choices, wise choices, which we're going to come on to in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
And I think my job is done.
Yeah.
In that area of her life, I've obviously done a good job, because that's when I will raise her to make good choices, to be a good, strong, independent woman. And it's a scary thing to allow your children to
fly. Well, we were talking about it, weren't we, at the weekend, and how, you know, what we did with Jen was that very early on, we released her to mix with people, whether it be adults or whether it be kids. And therefore, she doesn't find it difficult to mix with people now. But a lot of kids are held back by the parents. They don't let their kids mix with other kids, just in case.
Yeah.
And they don't want to mix with adults. And then, you know, they wonder why their kids never leave home.
No.
You know, they take forever to leave home.
Yeah.
Because you've mollycoddled them.
And they're not then prepared for that in the big bad world.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's, you know, part of being a parent is bringing them up so that they are ready as possible.
Yeah.
For the world. So you entrust them into God's care because you know that they're safe in His hands. And you know, when our daughter started driving, and I'm sure there's many mums out there who can just relate to the fact that you've allowed them out on their own behind the wheel, you're absolutely petrified. You've just got to entrust them into God's care because you know that they're safe in His hands.
And the very last thing we looked at was a great mum implants wisdom. Save the best to last, really.
Oh, so
because we know the Bible says wisdom is the principal thing.
Mm.
One of the most valuable things we could ever pass on to our kids is wisdom.
Absolutely.
But in order to pass it on, we've got to be seen to be making wise choices.
Yes.
And wise choices are not always popular choices.
No. Now, the way of the world has a very different way from the way of the Word.
Yeah.
And the Word says that wisdom is the principal thing. It is the most... The world has a way of changing its mind so often. So what is popular today won't be popular in five years' time.
No.
And so we can't go with the ways of the world.
No.
But to know that the Bible is a rock-solid, stable Word that never changes, wisdom is the principal thing. Just training your children to be wise in their choices, to make informed decisions, not just decisions, but to get all the information about something and then be able to make an informed decision.
And not cautious, not in terms of holding back.
You want them to live by faith.
Definitely living by faith, but like you say, informed, balanced. And that's what a great mum does. She keeps the balance. Whatever you're doing this weekend, I hope that that's helped this week in making you all that you're called to be as you really travel this journey of being a mum, which is an ongoing journey. You know,
oh,
you don't
never
ever
ends.
Stop this journey.
No, no, no.
So,
it wasn't a career choice. It's a lifestyle.
We realise it's an ongoing challenge.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing this weekend, we are celebrating 1 year in Weston-super-Mare this weekend.
Party time.
So if you're anywhere near Pratt, we'd love to see you and join in the celebrations.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing, we'll see you again on Monday.
Bye-bye.
Bye.